Are you ready to go the distance? In 2000, an Olympic swimmer got ready to dive into history. His name was Eric Moussambani, and he hoped to win his first ever Olympic race, and if he got fast enough time, he could even compete in the finals. His opponents were skilled, and as they all lined up at the edge of the pool, something remarkable happened. The two athletes he was competing against jumped into the pool too early. They were both disqualified and out of the race. Suddenly, Eric found himself in an unusual situation. Here was a swimmer in a race all by himself, no one to compete against. All he had to do to win was jump in the water. And that he did. It wasn't pretty. As you can see here, he didn't quite have the form of other swimmers. And that makes sense. He'd only first learned to swim 8 months earlier. Even worse, he'd never been in a pool this size before. And before we start laughing too hard at him flailing away, consider this. For the past few months, he'd only trained himself in a small pool without a coach or roped off lanes. And here's the worst part. He'd only trained for a 50-meter race. Yep, he was stunned when he discovered he'd have to swim a distance that was twice that long. But even with all that, all he had to do to win his first Olympic race was jump in and try. Now, 100 meters is a long way to swim. The crowd didn't even know if he would make it that far. While he was out there, he himself didn't even know if he'd make it. He felt shattered and embarrassed at the possibility of failing in front of so many. But something happened. The crowd there began to cheer and encourage him on to the finish. He later said it helped him greatly. And although he had the slowest time for that race in the history of the Olympic Games, Eric Moussambani inched down his lane, thrashing at the water towards his goal. He was going to make it. The crowd roared as Eric completed his race, and he later said that he felt like he just won a gold medal. It was a heroic performance, even though other Olympic athletes could go twice as far and in faster time. It didn't matter, everyone was still cheering just as if he'd just won the gold medal. They called him Eric the Eel, and for a while he was one of the most famous athletes at the Olympics. Days earlier, he was nervous and scared. But all Eric had to do to be an Olympic champion was just jump in. In life, that's all you have to do as well. God's not given us a spirit of fear, but the spirit of a champion. And although as we go through life sometimes, it may feel like we're just flailing our arms about, it's important to remember this. Because of what God has done for us, all you have to do to be a winner is jump in and try.